told that I'm in Wales. And Wales has a special place in my heart and reflects much of what sees me here today. That warmth is reflected in that character and that spirit that is melodious in the words, the presence, the experience, and the reason that you're here. So, I've chosen to find out, say good morning to you, in a language that suggests that sport brings us together. And everything that this conference should be about, this should be a pretty interesting day. You'll note by my size that I was almost messy with the size, but on the basis of why I'm chairing the day, it is to make sure that everything is in order. So behaviour equals performance. So on the basis of that, I hope that we will have a day that will be truly eventful and memorable. Because we are in a pretty unique place and time. A time where sport is being considered in its ability to address a number of social challenges. And the culture of sport has never been more important in the lives of young people and communities here in Wales and throughout the UK. But in Wales, you do things differently. That's why the Y Sport Conference in getting Wales moving has never come at a more important time. That time, that moment and place is here. And it is on that basis that the agenda for today, I believe, will lead to something quite historic. Something that will take us forward with an action. I'm a doing person. So I hope that as doing people and people who care about sport within your respective professions and the personal commitment you have, is that this whole day will also be enjoyable, but the networking, the contacts will build on something that will take us forward. Why sports, with the support of Icon Training, have provided this opportunity? But as I said earlier, the Legislative Act that sees the only country in the UK able to see something done because it is legislative law. That means if we don't do it, we get in trouble. With that, we should therefore hear from the opening address the Cabinet Secretary for Economy and Infrastructure for the Welsh Government, who will tell us why it's so important that we actually get Wales moving, and more importantly, look at why we need to get this right. Can I introduce, by way of this morning's opening address, Kingston?
It's an absolute pleasure to be with you, and can I thank you for arranging the Y Sports Conference, and also thank Icon for inviting me to deliver this address before you. I am absolutely thrilled to be part of an important occasion that recognises the importance of being active to the health and well-being of the people of Wales, the people of the United Kingdom, and in turn, to contribute to our growing prosperity. Societal changes, there is no doubt, have designed physical activity out of our lives. Few of us have manual jobs. Technology dominates at home and in the workplaces, the two places where we spend most of our time. And the desire for convenience and speed often trumps opportunities for physical activity. We are the first generation that needs to make a conscious choice to be physically active. Conversely, we also have a better understanding of the importance of physical activity to our well-being and our prosperity. We know that adults are meant to participate in 75 minutes of vigorous physical activity a week, or 150 minutes of moderate physical activity per week, and that children and young people should engage in moderate physical activity for at least 60 minutes. But far too few of us do just this, for many reasons, because we don't have time, because we don't make that conscious decision, because we don't have the support or the opportunities or the facilities. And if you take young people in particular, the statistics are, I'm afraid, pretty shocking. Only 16% of 15-year-old boys, and even worse, only 8% of girls at that age are physically active for an hour a day. This is despite all of us knowing now that physical activity is good for us. When surveyed, the people of Wales have identified physical activity as being one of the top five perceived contributors to health and well-being, and that poor levels of physical activity are therefore one of the top five contributors to poor health and well-being. And we know that physical activity on a regular basis can reduce the many risks of physical ailments, the risk of coronary heart disease, stroke, type 2 diabetes, cancer, obesity, and crucially, mental illness as well. The personal costs to individuals can obviously be significant in terms of a lower quality of life, restricted opportunities, and potentially premature death. And there are societal costs too, huge societal costs. Just here in Wales, £35 million spent every year treating diseases that are caused by a lack of physical activity. Now, you may wonder why I, as the Economy and Transport Cabinet Secretary, is so interested in getting Wales moving, in encouraging people to be physically active. Well, it's not just because this, I believe, is the big societal challenge of our times. It's because of huge consequences for our economy, for our society, for our levels of prosperity and our well-being. It's been estimated that around £15 billion a year is being lost to the British GDA in terms of a lack of productivity in the workplace. Not just people who can't turn up because they're too stressed or depressed or anxious, but because when they do turn up, they're not productive enough in the workplace because of mental health ailments, often low level, but which could be treated through enhancing people's levels of physical activity. But I do recognise that in order to challenge this, in order to change this, in order to bring about a society that is more contented, more physically active, more cohesive, there are a multitude of solutions. The issues are very complex. And it's not just about education. We often think that educating people about the benefits of physical activity is the key. I think by now, everybody knows the benefits of physical activity. We need to ensure that there are opportunities for people to be more physically active and to support people in building their motivation and capability to participate. And I'm going to talk about my contribution, my department's contribution, the Welsh Government's contribution to this agenda. Being active isn't just about being particularly sporting. It can be, for many people, it can be that, but it's about moving. It's about being more active on a daily basis. It's about building moderate exercise into our daily routines, and it's about making positive choices that can improve our health and well-being. It could be about taking the stairs rather than the lift, walking in our lunch breaks, or walking or cycling to schools and workplaces. And the Welsh Government and my department is committed to increasing physical activity levels as part of our approach to promoting good health and mental health. This is highlighted in our recent national strategy, Prosperity for All, which sets out the ambition to build a Wales that is healthy and active, that is prosperous and secure, that is ambitious and learning, and which is united and connected. And to do that, we need to demonstrate the impact of physical activity on health and well-being. Prosperity for All makes our intention to work differently clear, and physical activity impacts across a number of portfolios, including the world economy. I'll give you some examples. Active travel. With our Active Travel Act, we have put in place the right framework to improve opportunities for people in Wales to make everyday journeys on foot or by bike. And over the coming years, we will see more and more high quality walking and cycling routes that connect people with where they need to go as part of delivery of this act. But the workplace is also a key driver for change. Modern workplaces make a huge difference to improve the health and well-being of staff. And this can have a significant impact on the economy regarding job satisfaction, staff retention, and increased productivity, as I've already highlighted. We expect those organisations that we invest in to do the same, and envisage a collaborative approach to aid promotion of healthier lifestyles and for employers to invest in well-being of the workforce. Our Healthy Working Wales programme is one of the ways that we bring people together to improve health in the workplace. Based on evidence of what works, Healthy Working Wales supports working age people through their employers to stay fit and stay healthy so that they can remain in employment or return to work following a period of ill health. Employers are supported to recognise that the workplace can have a positive effect on employees' health and well-being, and that ill health is not necessarily a barrier to effective working. Further, providing employment and maintaining people in work is a positive way of supporting individuals who are recovering from health problems. And the programme consists of a range of services that help people to improve their performance at work and to reduce the cost and burden of ill health and absence in the workplaces across Wales. To date, 3,500 employers employing around 36% of the working age population in Wales are actively engaged in this particular programme. And there have also been some great examples of where sport has proved to be a catalyst for helping to turn particularly young lives around. Working with police and local authorities, some youngsters have turned their backs on crime and unproductive lives and become excellent, superb role models and productive members of their communities. Encouraging increased participation in sport is not straightforward, and no single organisation or individual can be responsible for this challenge. The recent review of Sport Wales has provided us with the opportunity to establish new ways of working together and a chance to demonstrate the value and wider impact of sport on Welsh society, including, I think, its considerable benefits to the economy. Sport Wales is now working on a comprehensive engagement plan to kickstart ongoing two-way dialogue with a variety of organisations and individuals across various sectors with a view to shaping a new vision for sport in Wales. And it's vital that the development of this vision ensures that sport plays a central role in the lives of more people in Wales and is recognised and valued for the impact that it undoubtedly has. This vision, I think, will also demonstrate how sport meets the policy goals set out in the National Strategy Prosperity for All. And finally, I'd like to offer you insight now into the major policy change that I and my department will be offering as part of the National Strategy. We recently published Prosperity for All, an Economic Action Plan. And at the heart of our new delivery for economic development will be a new economic contract between business and government. A simple, transparent form of support that will see a contract between government and business established on the basis of 4 points criteria. One will concern fair work, another will concern decarbonisation, a further point will concern the promotion of health, and in particular mental health and well-being in the workplace. Every business seeking to draw down support from Welsh Government will have to comply with this new economic contract. And so we will be offering for the first time as a government, not just the opportunity, but the incentive for businesses to promote the workforce being more physically active. I think this could be a game-changing policy initiative, especially if we extend it right across £6 billion of procurement opportunities in Wales every year. It shows how we are working across government, how we are using all levers available to us to get people more active, to make people more productive, to enhance the well-being of our nation, and to spread prosperity for all. I'd like to thank you all for listening, and I look forward to hearing your views today. The Ockham Barrier.